¿Qué esconde Estados Unidos?
Les hago referencia a una conversación que vamos a tener pronto, porque si estás cargado de deudas, de tarjetas de crédito, siempre me ocupo de quienes viven aquí, porque sé que hay que también ocuparse del día a día, que es bien duro en este país. Ocuparse del día a día, que es bien duro en este país. Yo no sé si sabían que la deuda nacional en tarjetas de crédito ha alcanzado esa asombrosa cifra de $1.320.000.000. Y eso no es todo, porque además hemos roto récords históricos de morosidad. La gente no paga.
I feel like only in America can you need medical assistance that you can't afford to get. And in order to get government help, you have to make under a certain amount. So if you're someone who's like, makes $60,000 a year, you don't qualify for any help, but you can't actually afford to get your child the services that they need. But if I quit my job and I go work for McDonald's, I can live off the government and then she can have the help that she needs. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. Make it make sense.
La causa.
So the specific question is, would you strengthen or modify any of these economic sanctions programs, particularly Russia, including the pipeline you mentioned?
Well, it's a great question. The problem with what we have with sanctions, and I was a user of sanctions, but I put them on and take them off as quickly as possible because ultimately it kills your dollar and it kills everything the dollar represents, and we have to continue to have that be the world currency. I think it's important. I think it would be losing a war. If we lost the dollar as the world currency, I think that would be the equivalent of losing a war. That would make us a third world country, and we can't let it happen. So I use sanctions very powerfully against countries that deserve it, and then I take them off. Because look, you're losing Iran, you're losing Russia. China is out there trying to get their currency to be the dominant currency, as you know better than anybody. All of these things are happening. You're losing so many countries because there's so much conflict with all of these countries that you're going to lose that.